Cleveland All-Star Weekend, and one man who's going to feature for a long time to come is our very own budding superstar. Speak of Josh Giddey, who joins me now. Josh, how cool is this?
Cam, it's great. It's great to have a bunch of Aussies in Cleveland at All-Star Weekend, so I'm loving it, having a great time.
Hey, we'll touch on the Rising Star first. How did you find it last night? It's a little bit of a different format. Sometimes it has a bit of that All-Star feel, low intensity, but you fitted right in, man. How'd you like it?
Yeah, it's obviously fun. It's a new format, you know, opposed to the World versus USA. But the new format was good, I think. You know, trying to get a feel for whether guys were playing hard or not was the hard part. You know, you had to go out there. I wasn't sure if I was going to defend guys hardly or what I was going to do. So once the game gets in the flow of it, you pick things up. But fun time, good to meet all the other rookies and sophomores. It's obviously some of the best in the league, so it was a fun night.
Now, I want to ask you this straight off the top, and you tell me if I'm 100% wrong here, okay? But I got told about 3 or 4 years ago, right now we're sitting in the lobby, there's NBA superstars everywhere, you're one of them, that there was a couple of AFL clubs really coming hard for you. Now, is this true? Because had you have said, I'm going to stay and play AFL, this wouldn't be happening right now and we would be missing watching you do your thing. Was there a couple of AFL clubs, maybe a black and white, that come hard?
I think there was, yeah. I don't know too much details about it, but yeah, I mean, when I was 15 or 14, 15, that was the decision I had to make, was footy, basketball. Obviously, when I got the scholarship to go to the AIS, that was when I had to decide, and obviously took that, and you know, never looked back, and don't regret the decision at all, obviously, but I still love footy. I still wish I could play it now, but yeah, definitely was a big footy guy back in my day.
I'm glad, we're glad, the entire Australian basketball fandom are glad right now, because this is cool, and you're playing so well. I loved your tweet the other day. You loved the garden. What was it like going to the Mecca and just throwing another triple-double down?
Yeah, that was obviously a, you know, awesome place to play. The atmosphere, you know, you hear so many stories, you know, you see so many things on TV about the garden, and to be in there, it's an unbelievable experience. That was a game I had circled on my calendar for a long time. Obviously, I had to wait a long time of the season to get there, but you know, to go and do what we did there, undermanned on the road in overtime, was a big win, and can't wait to go back there.
Are your teammates calling you Oscar Robertson Jr. yet? But this is, for us, it's nuts. Are you taking it in what you're actually doing?
Yeah, it's surreal. I mean, it happens so fast. You know, you have, you know, a historic performance one night, and you got a game the next night. So you can't sit around and kind of sit on your high horse for too long. You kind of got to put it in the past and move forward. But yeah, my teammates are awesome. They've been great. You know, they're great for me. They're in the right spots. They finish well around the ring, so they make my life easy.
How do you find that? Like in the NBL, where you also had some triple doubles and you played really well in that year with Adelaide, you play well, you have a triple double. We do our thing in the media, we talk about you, and you've got 4 or 5 days to sort of decompress it and move on. But of course, sort of live in the moment a bit. How have you found that quick transition for back to backs or 3 games in 4 nights?
Look, it's tough. I mean, there's times you're playing, you know, on the road, you fly out, you land in a city. Like we landed one time in. We got to Cleveland at 7 in the morning and had a game that night just because it was plane problems and stuff like that. So anything can happen, and that's a life of just being an NBA player. You know, there's so many unexpected things. It's such a hectic schedule with 82 games that you got to take care of your body. You know, all that kind of things. Those little things really add up over a course of an 82-game season. So obviously it's a lot more games than I've ever played in my life. The NBL season is not nowhere near this long. So I love it personally because we don't train as much, which is the one benefit of playing so many games. But yeah, I'm a big fan of the 82-game season.
Obviously, Ben Simmons' situation's played out the way it is. He's now going to play for Brooklyn. Do you have any type of conversations or relationship with Ben Simmons while he's been going through what he has been going through?
Yeah, we spoke a little bit, but I mean, he's, you know, what he went through, it's kind of best to just give him space. I didn't want to harass him too much about that, but yeah, I'm praying that in the future, me and him could team up for Australia. You know, I think if he plays, it's only going to increase the chances of a gold medal so much more. So I'm really happy for him. He's found the situation in Brooklyn that he wants to be in, and I'm looking forward to, you know, seeing him back on the floor and playing against him.
All right. This is not something I say with a great deal of pride, but it was about 2 a.m. in a Cleveland bar this morning. I got in a fairly heated discussion with a local who continues to tell me that Evan Mobley's the rookie of the year. And I said, no. Josh Giddey's doing what no one else has been able to do. Youngest, second youngest, third youngest, triple doubles. Oscar Robert. Are you the rookie of the year? You want my side, right?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I think so. But, you know, credit to Evan. He's been awesome this year for a really, you know, good Cleveland team. So I think it's going to be a tight race, but at the end of the year, if I don't win it, you know, it's not going to be too much, you know, too much weight on my shoulders. So I'm not overly worried. If I win it, great. If not, you know, we move on to the next year. But he's had a hell of a year.
Hey, staying in this hotel, 2 years ago you were hitting the game winner in the under-20 nationals. 12 months ago you were doing what you do for the Adelaide 36ers, and then you go to the NBA draft. Now you're sitting in a lobby and you fit in perfectly with these superstars on All-Star Weekend. But do you still get a little awestruck? Is there someone that you walk past or played against and you're like, hang on a second, this is nuts?
Yeah, I mean, all of the guys, like, you know, LeBron, Steph, Giannis, whenever you step on the floor with those guys, it's like, it's a surreal moment because 12 months ago, I was on TV, you know, sitting on my couch watching them play in the finals, do their thing, playing 2K with them. So it's all surreal, but... you know, you kind of have to switch from being a fan to a, you know, competitor in a matter of seconds. You know, there's times where I want to go up, just introduce myself, but, you know, I'm in the NBA playing against them. So, you know, it is surreal being able to step on the floors, you know, some of the greatest to ever do it.
Who's been the toughest matchup for you? What's the tough cover that at times you're like, oh, hang on, I'm in real trouble here?
God, I mean, switched on to Steph a few times. I mean, I don't usually guard these star players. We've got Lou Dort, one of the best in the league, to do that. So I'm lucky in that sense. But when I have to switch on to guys like Steph, he was the toughest one. It's like you see him on TV doing things and you think, you know, just put your hand up. It's that easy. But it's really not. He shoots some tough, tough, you know, step backs, threes from all over the floor. So he was probably the toughest one I've had to guard.
Mate, you're a superstar. And as I said, you fit in just perfectly on this stage, on this weekend, and what has been an outstanding season so far, mate. Keep doing what you're doing. We'll talk soon.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Gary.